Let us now look at example 1b. This is actually an extension of example 1a, except in this case, for the billet ball, we are interested in finding the average net force that's acting on the ball during the collision. Okay, so let us look at how to use Newton's second law to actually apply to this problem. So we use our new form of Newton's second law, and we know that by Newton's second law, the force that's acting on the ball is equal to the rate of change of momentum on the ball. So what's the average net force acting on the ball? Now, if you cannot remember, what you can do is think of a physical quantity, perhaps that you have learned before, where there's an instantaneous and you want to find average. And we actually have done it in kinematics. And if you recall, I'm just going to spin off a little bit for a while. I'm going to use velocity. Our average velocity, how did we find? We start off with instantaneous velocity first. We know that it is the rate of change of displacement with respect to time. So how did we find average velocity? Average velocity we found by looking at total displacement over the total time taken. You can actually think of another quantity in kinematics. We also have the concept of average and instantaneous. If you recall, acceleration, the instantaneous acceleration is actually dv dt, which is the rate of change of velocity with respect to time. And when we want to find average acceleration, we took the total change in velocity over the total time taken. So if you look at this, you can start seeing that there is actually a relationship between the instantaneous quantity and the average quantity. So similarly down here, we have f equals to dp dt. If you make a guess, and I hope you can see the relationship between all these, then you'll be able to tell that actually the average force, what we want to see is the total effect. So it's the total change in momentum of the ball divided by the total time taken. Now, I'm going to first focus on the magnitude of this average value. Earlier on in our question, we found that the magnitude of the change in change in momentum is 0.23. Okay, so this is actually found earlier in 1a. For this question, we have one extra information. The interval of contact between the billet ball and the wall is 0.100 seconds. So that is the time where the ball is actually changing momentum. So that's the time interval. So this would be 0.100 seconds. And that will work out be 2.3 Newton. But we know that force is actually a vector quantity. So we need to also state the direction of this force. So what's the direction of this force? If you look back at this equation, it will actually tell you what is the direction, because what we can see is the direction is actually determined by the change in momentum of the ball as well. And earlier on in our question, we know that the change in momentum of the ball is vertically downwards. So the direction of the force is actually downwards as well. And if I put it on a diagram, then it would be acting on the ball during collision. So it would be at this point, and this would be the average force on the ball. Okay, and it's acting vertically downwards. Now, I want to extend the question a little bit because sometimes the question, instead of asking you what is the average net force that's acting on the ball, it will ask you what is the average force acting on the wall during the collision. So what causes the wall to experience a force? It's actually the ball, correct? So can you see that there are now two objects of consideration that's interacting with each other? There's actually the ball and the wall itself. If you recall, we actually have a Newton's law that actually talks about interaction between two bodies, and that is Newton's third law. And Newton's third law tells us that if a force acts on A and it's by B, okay, there will be an equal and opposite force that is on B by A. So in this case, if I am interested in the force that is on the wall, and it is actually by the ball. It will therefore also be equals in magnitude, but in opposite direction, so it should be upwards. Okay? And this is us using Newton's third law. And if I also want to put this on the diagram, this is acting on the wall. So what we will have is it will have a force on the wall equal in magnitude, all right, opposite in direction, and this is on the wall, okay, by the ball. And that's it.